Okay, so the latest Man City transfer news. There's a lot to cover today. I've been away in Greece for 10 days. I just thought I'd do a quick update. A couple of new names entered the frame for Man City. We'll start with Felix Correia, who basically come out of nowhere. It's a name that's come out of nowhere. Photographs have been taken at Lisbon Airport last night, flying to Manchester to complete a move to Man City. Now, everyone gets excited thinking, you know, is this João Felix? But it's not. It's a totally different player. Felix Correia is age 18. He's a Portuguese right winger and he's currently plays for the Sporting Academy in Portugal. He's a right winger, can play central up front as well. Also can play as a slightly deeper attacking midfielder. Now, this is not one to get too excited about. He's a young lad. He's never played for the Sporting senior team, so he's got no senior debut, but he is a very exciting young player. Now, 18, he's not going to set the world alight at the moment, because like I say, he hasn't played any senior football, but he's one of those signings that, you know, he's there for the future. Expect Man City to bring him in. I think that they're talking maybe £3-4 million possibly with add-ons. So it's not a lot of money. It's a little bit of a speculative gamble for the future. He's likely to be signed, put out on loan, and see how he develops. Now, seen a little bit of him, clips of him, and he is. He's exciting. He's a pacey 6-footer. Loads of confidence. Likes to drive at the defence. He can go down the wing, he can cut inside, he looks to have a nice shot on him, keeps the ball nice and close to him when he's dribbling. So, you know, he's got it all there. Now, he's come through the Sporting Academy, he's played at their under 15, under 17, under 19 level. He's also played for the Portuguese international team right from under 15 level. So under 15, under 16, under 17, under 18 and under 19. Now, his stats at under 19 aren't brilliant, but at under 18 he was scoring goals, doing assists at international level. So there's a prospect there. You know, time will tell with him. It's one of those that could take a year or two. He won't feature in the Man City team next year, but it's one maybe to revisit in a year or two. And you know, you never know on signings like this. So that's one to look at for the future. But a nice little signing, low risk, £3-4 million. Next one is the central defender. Really interesting sort of developments here. Now, obviously, all the talk has been about Harry Maguire and, you know, Leicester. There's even talk of them wanting up to £100 million for him. And Man City have been very good in the transfer market. When Pep Guardiola came in, they made what at the time people thought were big money signings. When you look back now in retrospect, they were probably very, very good value and cheap. But he built his team and now he's in that position where he can tinker and he can just pop people in as replacements as needed. He's under no pressure, he's under no stress to do anything straight away. Now, Man City won't be bought in, you know, they won't be sold something overpriced in the transfer market. They've put themselves in that position. And Harry Maguire at 80, 100 million, I can't see Man City paying that money. However, they may not buy at all. There's, you know, there's Laporte, there's Garcia, Stones and Otamendi. And, you know, they could just stick with what they've got and sort of see how the position is with Maguire in the transfer window in January or even next summer. But there has been rumours in the press about Otamendi that, you know, he was heavily involved in the 17-18 season, played a lot of matches, played well. Then last year in the 18-19 season, he was given a lot less opportunity. He was on the bench a lot. And, you know, understandably, probably frustrated with the amount of game time he was getting. Now, Pep Guardiola likes to rotate his central defenders, whether he's playing three at the back. He looks at the opposition and whether there's an aerial threat. And he, you know, he tends to switch his central defenders around depending on the type of opposition he's playing. So he needs the numbers there to rotate. He needs the numbers there for cover in case of injury and obviously to keep players on their toes. Now, Otamendi is currently playing in the Copa America with Argentina. He's having an absolutely superb tournament. He's 31 years old. you know, there's still another two or three good years left in him. I think who scored have got him rated as the third best player in the Copa America up to now. And he's playing in the semi-final, I think it's against Brazil today. So, you know, big match for him there. So you don't expect anything to happen, although there's rumours around Otamendi, you don't expect anything to happen while he's on international duty with Argentina. But there's Atletico Madrid apparently very interested, and a couple of other clubs sniffing around. And, you know, Otamendi, he could look at it two ways. He could say, look, we're company leaving, I'm going to get more opportunity this next year. He could be sort of saying, no, you know, I want to get on my way. And if a player really does want to go in this day and age, they are tended to let go. So if Otamendi goes, that does put the pressure a little bit more back on Pep Guardiola to fill that centre-back position. Now, Maguire, very split decision on the Man City fans. Some think he's a great signing, others think he's a donkey, to be honest. I personally think he's a very good player. Is he the best central defender in the world? No. Is he one of the best central defenders in England? Yes. His stats prove that he's a good player. I think playing for Leicester is a lot busier. It's a lot harder as a central defender to play for Leicester than it is to Man City. No disrespect to Leicester, but you do get more cover with Man City. So I feel in Man City he would fit absolutely superbly. Will they pay 800 million? No, they won't. But if Otamendi goes, then that may put the pressure a little bit back on. Now, a new name that's come into the frame sort of overnight is Leonardo Bonucci of Juventus, and Pep Guardiola is a long-term fan of him. You know, he's a very experienced, world-class defender. However, he is 32 years old. I think at Juventus they've got about five central defenders there, so there is an opportunity perhaps to bring in somebody a little bit older, more experienced, to see through the next year or two until the right opportunity for the right player at the right price comes along. So that's an interesting one to watch. Once the Copa America's over, to see what Otamendi's position is and see whether he is really adamant on moving or staying. And I'd be interested in your thoughts, what you think of Otamendi, Maguire and Bonucci. But there's a couple of options there. And, you know, Otamendi really is the key to what happens with that position and whether there's more pressure on Pep Guardiola to sign somebody before the season starts or leave it onwards. So that's the central defender position with Leonardo Bonucci, Harry Maguire. Leroy Sane, we'll just have a quick mention on him because, like I said, I've been away for 10 days. Bayern Munich obviously have been up to all sorts of tricks trying to manipulate a move there. My thoughts are that Leroy Sane wasn't happy last year, and if the right club had come along, I think he would have been pressuring the club to leave. It looks like he probably isn't over interested in Bayern Munich. Man City certainly don't want to sell him. And if he wasn't a Man City player and he was available on the market, he's the sort of player that you would be wanting to sign. So why would you want to sell him? But it was interesting on Monday to see him. He was really the main focus in the main photo shoot for the new kit. So that's a real statement out there to, you know, fans, to other clubs, to say, look, Leroy Sané is staying. Get your hands off, he's in the new kit, he's going to play next year. So that one's looking like he's staying. Rodri is the next one, central midfielder. I think this one's the key position for them, that really they want to get the signing done. And there's been rumours that the deal was going to happen yesterday, Monday. The deal was going to happen today. Not too sure what's going on there. There's again talk that it will happen over the next week or two. So you wonder what's quite delaying that one. Atletico have made provisions for him leaving, so it looks like it's going to happen. But until it's confirmed, until it's signed, anything can happen. So as of speaking now, Tuesday morning, Rodri is not yet signed. Imminent, expected soon, but anything could happen on that one. So all in all, there's been a lot of names mentioned with Man City in the transfer market, as you'd expect with a big club who you know want to stay on top and want to progress further in the Champions League next year. It's quite surprising that I go away for 10 days and that, you know, I expected there to be one or two signings made by the time I came back and their business done, ready for pre-season, and it's not. So it's quite surprising, quite quiet, that there's been a lot of obvious activity behind the scenes, lots of rumours, lots of press. But as of now, there is no actual signing. So I think in order of what may happen first, we've got Felix Correia, small signing there, 3-4 million. Probably likely to happen today over the next couple of days. Rodri, that's one that I really think needs to happen. And you know, it could happen this week, could happen next week. The Harry Maguire, the Leonardo Bonucci, that one will depend a lot on Otamendi, and probably won't see any movement until the Copa America's over and the run with Argentina's finished. Leroy Sane, I think we can pretty much say that one's put to bed and he's staying. But watch this space. If you like the videos, please subscribe and like below. Let me know your thoughts on all those players and what your thoughts on them. Would you take them? Would you stick with what you've got? You know, Man City are in no pressure. So I'd be interested to hear your thoughts because, football's a game of opinions and you know, I've got mine and I love to hear everybody else's. So please comment below. Thanks for watching again.